Hey everybody, it's Jake, and today I'm making a very, very lazy video. I didn't want to do any painting, so I decided to go over what I use to paint with my oil paints. And the first thing I have are my paintbrushes. I have a lot of paintbrushes that I use. They're specifically nothing specific. They're just a random assortment of brushes. It's a bunch of synthetic brushes, mainly you can get from Michaels online. You know, just cheap $5 pack of 10 brushes that are disposable and you throw them out anytime soon. I have a couple more expensive ones, like this Winsor & Newton here. That's a synthetic. I mainly use synthetics, but I do have two sable brushes, but they're not like your Kolinsky sables. They're just these Blix finest red sables that I got from dickblick.com, which is not an adult website. It's a art website, but you know, names. And you can use these paintbrushes with anything. I do go back and forth between oils and acrylics, and as long as you give them a good, nice cleaning after you're done using them, you can just switch back and forth between mediums as much as you want. I even go as far as priming with these brushes, like this big brush right here. I used it the other night for priming, and then I used it a couple days ago for doing the pre-glaze on the models in my last video. So you can go back and forth with these brushes as long as you give them a really good cleaning. This is my palette. It is a paper palette that I bought from Michaels. It is, you take the sheet of the paper and you rip it off and you got a fresh sheet of paper. But for the most part, I was on like a palette quest, and I had at one point a glass palette from a picture frame, was just a clear piece of glass. I like that, but it was a little too, it kept the paint too wet, especially for oils. I did the cardboard and parchment paper with the stick glue method. That's too much work. Could be honest. I mean, really, it's not too much work, but I'm lazy. Oh, and also I have these cups. These cups were also part of the palette experiment, but these are actually so much more useful than just as little metal palette holders. You can get these by like a pack of 25, and you can use them for anything. I put, like, on days where I know I'm just gonna be priming models by hand without the airbrush, I'll grab two of these, one for water, one for the primer, and just go. And that is all that's on my table, and maybe some paper towels. And it is the nicest way to just put stuff down on the table and paint without having to worry about grabbing, oh, I got a water palette, or I have a oil painting palette. It is very simple, and I recommend everybody goes gets these. And this is the thinner. I use the Speedball Mona Lisa odorless paint thinner. I have a nuclear-powered nose. Even after COVID, I can smell really faint smells, like they're right in front of my face sometimes. This stuff has a slight smell to it. It's not completely odorous. To somebody else, it may be odorless, but to me, it has a chemically smell. It's very faint, and I don't think it, like, you use a minuscule amount of stuff, so it's not going to give you any problems or anything, but you don't want to drown yourself in it. Like, you don't want to put the thinner up to your nose and sniff it like there is something in there you need to smell. It is toxic stuff. Well, I shouldn't say that. I don't know if it's exactly toxic, but it's not something you want to drink or anything like that. And back to the palette. I chose this palette because of how easy it is. It uses 40 sheets of paper. And it has like a coat, a treated coat on top of the paper. And as you can see here, this palette was used like a week ago before I filmed this footage. And I wanted to see if you could reuse this oil paint on here, which got globs of oil paint. You should be able to use it a week later. Stuff doesn't dry when it's in large quantities. And of course, you just take a little bit of thinner and you can put it on there. And this is a wet palette times 50,000 million, because with a wet palette you have to worry about mold the paint can dry out. The water is in there. This is like the best thing ever. It's just a sheet of paper with some old paint sitting on there. Now the paint that is thinned out, that is already spread out, that's completely dry. You can't reactivate that. That is a downside to this. But say you got a palette like this and you want to go back to square one, you just rip it off. And that is the advantage of this paper palette that I found at Michael's. Again, $10 Michael's. It's like 14 by 11 or something like that. It's a nice good size. It holds a lot of paint. I love this thing. I don't think I'm going to switch to anything else as far as palettes go. The cups and this prime material. As far as primer goes, I use exclusively Steinel Res. I tried Vallejo in the beginning and I did not like it. It chipped off. The Vallejo chipped off very, very easily after many, many models of using it. I just had a batch where it was like, I'm barely touching the models. And Steinel Res does not have that problem. Steinel Res, you can brush it on, you can put it through the airbrush. It is a very nice primer, has a very nice finish, and one coat is usually all you need. This right here, the Life Flesh, when I do that by hand, I do two coats. It dries within 15 minutes. You let it dry to the touch. It's not completely cured or settled. And then you go in with a second coat and you get very, very good coverage. This model here, it's a little bit splotchy. I was a little bit careless about the application of the primer, but it was still very, very good coverage because these were gray models and now it's this pinkish color. These two models here were, the one on the left is 3D printed, the one on the right is a red plastic from Privateer Press. And you can see it covers quite nicely and none of that color is poking through. That's the color that these models were before priming. This is the black primer. This was two coats because I did not cover every area at once, but that model is long since prime. It's been like a couple months since I primed that model. And I do have gray and white. These lighter colors usually require more than one coat if you're doing it by hand. Here is Lord Croak's throne. If you've ever put this model together, you know it's fine cast. You know it's a very white looking plastic or resin, whatever the hell fine cast was. And I actually have another model. This is the Slant Star Masters. This is comparison for what these unprimed and primed models look like. And the gray is a nice flat gray. It doesn't have a shine or a finish to it. It's very matte and I like painting over it. And the white primer. This primer is very thin out of the bottle. It doesn't require any thinning whatsoever, and this stuff does take more than maybe one or two coats to put on by hand with a brush. This Infinity model here is actually Zenithawed, so it didn't matter that much, but if you put it on by hand, I have quite a few models. I did a batch of flags from the Song of Ice and Fire miniatures games, and doing that by hand was shitty experience. I had to put like multiple coats over it to get true coverage. Now here you can see this model is not Zenithal, this is straight white primer, and that took maybe 2-3 coats of the primer. I don't usually like priming over or painting over white. I'm very bad at getting all the nooks and crannies and blacking everything out. So if you look at some of my earliest models, and this is probably true for most new painters, when you do straight white, if you don't get the nooks and crannies, if you look at the model, like no one else will notice this, but you'll notice this, you will see the white spots. And that to me, I hate that. I do not like being able to see like white spots or missed spots on models where you can still see the primer. And that's why painting or priming in black is the recommended way to go. But wood oils, because this is only partially true. See, when you do black primer with oils, the paint is just a darker shade of what it would be with white. It's almost the same with acrylics, but it takes a little bit more work with the oils. And here are my varnishes. I have the Liquitex Gloss and the Liquitex Matte. I do have the AK Interactive Ultra Matte too, but I couldn't find that for the video. And with the oil paints, I tend to find that matte varnish is the best. If you put gloss varnish on oils, you're going to be getting glow-in-the-dark models just by the reflection of the light coming off of them, so I don't want that at all. And the matte varnish gives it a very nice finish. I got a couple models in comparison. It's almost a satin finish if you have really, really, really glossy oil paints. But if you have matte oil paints, which there are matte oil paints, it is a very nice matte finish after you put the varnish on, and it looks really good. And as far as cleaning my brushes, oil thinner, you just scrub the brushes in there, get as much oil out as you can, and then I take it to the bathroom, some warm water, and this Master's brush cleaner, just like a soapy wax that you dip the brush in water, dip the brush then into the cleaner, you know, lather your hair up, and you just repeat the process, rinse and repeat. And I also got tons and tons of old pill bottles, like vitamin pills, Tums, that I use for holders, and I have only one of these dinky ass Citadel holders. And what I use for that is just sticky tack, the blue tack that you can get from like Walmart. That's where I get my blue tack from. I couldn't find it at first when I was pretending, but then I saw it off in the corner. And here's the blue tack. I see the color of the blue tack here. It should be as blue as that cap. And when I say as blue as, I mean the brand new sticky tack is as blue as that cap. And when it starts to turn green like that, it's getting old. It's a little bit rougher to work with. You might want to think about throwing it out. I use it as a stress ball. That's why it turns so green. And it's like, I could take a big chunk of this stuff and I just sit there as I'm like browsing on the web or something, making a stress ball, squeezing it, shaping it, and it's just like, I go through this stuff really easily. Yeah, that's everything I use for oil painting. It's a lot nicer to just sit down with the oil paints than it is with acrylics, because I feel like with the acrylics, there's like a setup where you gotta get your wet palette, you gotta put the water, you gotta get a cup of water, you gotta do all this extra preparation that I don't feel like I'm doing with the oil paints, where it's literally just put the paint on the palette, get the little cup of oil thinner, and start painting. It is literally that simple, and it's less of a hassle, and that's what I do. And I just wanted to share it with everybody, because I didn't paint anything, and it is Friday. I'm still not painting anything. I'm in the process of putting in a crap ton of models. I bought the Crisis Protocol starter box, and a whole bunch of other models that I'm assembling, and on top of 3D printing stuff, so that's why I didn't want to paint. So, thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe to stand up.